You want more of the washer dryer from my previous video? Here I am, your sweet super self, silkish smooth principessa Silkita. I am wise, I am intelligent, and I'm generous, sharing myself with you here on my Atacalacho and outside. That washer dryer in San Francisco, in that house Yaiki had bought. Yeah, I moved in with him as he invited me. He came to pick me up from Mexico. In that house, the washer dryer was so conveniently located because it was in the kitchen, but not really, because the kitchen sort of kind of had ended. It was almost like a little passage to now the outdoor garden. So right next to it. That was such an aesthetic concept. And on the other, because in Marin County, I had to walk all the way through the entire house, regardless which bedroom from, and go to the garage. Do you know how unwelcoming a garage is? Because I like to run around bare feet. So I had to install a little carpet or a little loafer. How do you even say that in English? Like a piece of a carpet. But you know how filthy that gets? If it's in the garage and the door open and close and car in, car out. Yeah, it's next to stupid. So what's the sauna he bought? He bought an infrared sauna as he chose to now stop drinking and detox. He read a book, Detox or Die. So yeah, that's what it was. Get the toxins out of his body. He got it on eBay and it was very inexpensive, he said, because he had to build it himself. They sent the parts, but he was good at building things. It was a tiny little thing where they could two people sit next to each other, tight. No, I did often sauna, but I prefer to be alone than I could put my feet up. Infrared. It's just a little thing, like a little digital thing at the side. And it was always in the garage because there was no more space. Overlooking the car. And you have to go there, you know, it's not really that aesthetic. I don't like it. Of course I did it because that's what it was. But in San Francisco, the washer dryer had also the super convenience to be one on top of each other, not next to each other. So you put your basket or whatever you have on the floor. Yeah, because the floor was pretty and new. So you grab your clothes and you put it in the washer up. When it's done, the basket can still sit there, right? Yeah, you could put it in a cabinet if you don't want to see it. Well, the thing is, I did not have plastic baskets. Or did I? No, I don't remember now. I like pretty baskets, so I don't mind watching them. But yeah, you can put them away, meanwhile. Anyhow, when the washing is done, you take the basket. You don't have to, though, but you could. And you grab the whole thing and throw it down below in the dryer, just in case something falls. Yeah, in reality, you don't need that basket until it's done. And then you put the basket back in and throw everything in there. That's so convenient. I don't know, it's just how many moves do you do, right? It was a fairly sized washer and dryer, just regular, for a family. Because it's easier to grab the clothing from above and put it below than it is to grab it from, like, say, one side and then pull it all the way over to the other side, somehow with the gravity and the movement. You have the risk that something falls, and you definitely, for safety, would like to have a basket on the floor. It doesn't matter, one move, but if you do it so often and constantly, it adds up. It makes you feel tired. I do not like the washing machines which are the opening from above. That's like an old method. That method is inspired in when people had to wash their clothing without a washing machine. They would put it in a bucket.
So weak in the knees, I can hardly speak. I lose all control. Something takes over me in a daze. Your love's so amazing, it's not a phase. I want you to stay with me by your side. I swallow my.